Hello and welcome to another episode of Goa 365's Story Behind the Story. You can't say it's a new episode, it's a continuation of the previous one wherein we discussed what is the present current situation, as my panelists I'm sure will tell you, as of today, of the political situation in the state. We have discussed in the previous one, we have given an approximate overall some overall numbers which would change given things that could happen in Bardez and North in general. And now let me go on to the South. Now I would like Viraj to again give a general thing in South before I move on to our other panelists. Viraj.
So in the South, Congress is expected to get around 6 to 9 seats. BJP is expected to get around 5 to 7 and others is expected to get around 4 to 6. Now, if you look at South Goa, heart of it is Salsette. It has 8 seats. So that is where BJP is going down. They are expected to win. They're not expected to win even a single seat in Salsette. Most of their seats are down, lower South Goa, the border, Sangaik, Kankon and those areas. So they are Sangaik, Kepe talukas, Sawadde talukas, they are expected to get around 3 to 4 seats. Marmagao, they are expected to get 1 to 2 seats. Daboling is most likely for them and they have a good chance in Vasco. And Ponda taluka, they are expected to win 1 to 2 seats. So Salsette, it looks like they are going to draw a blank. Apart from that, their seats are spread out across the other areas. Coming to the Congress, interesting thing to note is last time they won 6 out of 8 in Salsette. One went to Goa Forward and one went to NCP. This time around, that others is coming into that space. Basically, TMC and AAP, they are expected to win around 3 to 4 seats. Congress is going down to 3 to 4 in Salsette and Goa Forward is expected to retain its lone seat, Fathodda. So overall, we have a figure of 5 to 7 for the BJP, 6 to 9 for the Congress and 4 to 6 which goes to others.
Yeah, before I move in, I would like to go to Gurdas Bhav and then to Ashley on starting off with Salsette and generally moving on to the rest of South. Gurdas Bhav.
Salsette is like Congress or India, BJP and Gale. And the Bumba Kiri Ashley Paka Pumatwara. Very concurring. Candidate BJP Outlet, independent outlet, and BJP support Gatli. Even Naveli also, whether they are BJP will contest on their own in their symbol or they will go independent. It's a very good trip. I agree with this survey as on today. But I'm to Makaisaki Patwada Prahani Madasanga. Alliance Congress is at least Kanaja Makadun Dubaha. Do they have announced? I got a go of our party, good luck.
Fathodda.
Only Fathodda. And Shivoli, I don't know what will happen to Vinod Pallekar. Whether he is in Goa Forward or whether he joined BJP. Still uncertainty is there. So, this is Elan Zalinani. Well, Fathodda, Vijay may lose. It is what I feel. As per my experience of so many 40 years in journalism. I think that Elan Zalinani is
okay.
Safe.
Okay.
Otherwise, BJP is may this time take over.
I tend to believe that Salsette will vote very constituency wise. It will not be Salsette. Earlier you had that picture.
Congress.
That picture is no longer there.
Yes.
So it's going to be constituency wise. Now again Salsette, BJP is a zero factor in 4 of the constituencies. Okay, Veli, it is not a factor at all. Benauli, it is not a factor at all. Naveli, it is some factor. Naveli is some factor. Kunkolim is some factor. Margao, it was a factor as long as Digambar was with them. Now that Digambar is not there with them, they are a factor, but they stand no chance of winning that seat. And Fathodda, they are a factor. So these 4 seats, Other than these four seats, the BJP has absolutely no say in any of the other seats. Okay. So, with Congress not being the same as it was, again it is facing the same problem as Bardes. It does not have a towering leader. Of course, it has Digambar. But Digambar, Digambar is not beyond Margaon boss. Please, Digambar is not beyond the twin constituencies of Margaon and Fatorda. Because he's never been that way. He was earlier with the BJP, no, he was not in the Congress. So, in that sense, so if Digambar was a factor, let us say Digambar was a factor across Salset, your Reginald would never have quit the Congress.
Nor Louisine.
Louisine is a leader, was a leader. Was a leader to some extent. Not across this thing. But then you had these three, four leaders together in the Congress for a long time. Therefore, Salset was a Congress bastion. It is no longer a Congress bastion. It is a non-BJP bastion. That is how we can call it today. Okay. So it will depend a lot on who are the individual candidates in each of the constituencies and how the situation is as far as who are the candidates in fray. For example, let us start with Kurtori. Until a month ago, he was declared a candidate by the Congress, Reginald, and he was pretty much on the winning pedestal or whatever you call it. With this change, it has become a totally uncertain seat. We cannot say that Kurtori is a certainty either this side or that side as of today because of that change. Now Reginald has quit the Congress and he's joined the TMC. Of course, Reginald is also an individual factor. Okay, he's won that seat thrice in a row. He first defeated Francisco Salina. So he is a factor as an individual. But then is that enough to be a winner? That's the question mark. Obviously, the Congress is not going to leave Kurtori a blank. They are definitely going to put up a candidate, whoever it is. And that candidate is going to, for sure, slice at least 2,500-3,000 votes.
If it is Moreno, it will be more.
Whoever, whether it is Moreno, whether it is Shalom, or whether it is that Joseph Vaz, or whether it is that Basil from Kamurli Panchayat, Sarpanch of Kamurli. They are definitely going to get 2,500-3,000 votes. That is going to come from Reginald's share.
Yes.
So that makes him not a certain winner for sure, uncertain. So obviously, so the point I'm trying to make is it is going to depend on who the local candidate is for on which party, how many candidates are going to be there in each constituency, and how well those candidates can mobilize the local. You know how mobilization happens. Yeah. So. Salset, I don't think is going to vote like a taluka. Salset is going to vote individual candidates.
Okay, I'd like to interject in this. Actually, if you go to see, probably Congress is pretty strong in two constituencies, as far as what I can see. One is Nuwe, and second is in Margao. Besides that, I don't see the Congress saying that, okay, we can win. Of course, even then in Nuwe, again depends on candidate. But if Alesh gets the Congress ticket, he'll probably sail through. I don't know. But this is what I feel. But the others, say Kukole, surprising, is again a BJP, the 50-50% chance are there. Fatorda, go forward, BJP. Now in Veli, in Naveli, and in Benavali, Congress is not discussed, I don't know. And now NCP is also not discussed because Churchill has gone to TMC. It is TMC and up. So this is a very surprising. I don't know what do your figures say and what do the panelists
think? So basically, you are right. Nuwe and Margaon is where they are strongest. Kumkolim, BJP is trailing. So we've got the data favoring Congress.
Okay.
Velim Filipneri is strong, but there is a anti wave going against him because currently he is in the BJP. Mm-hmm. And Congress as a party is the strongest there. Now, the problem is they have three candidates, Benjamin Silva and Joe Dias, and then your Sarpanch from Velim. So, who gets the ticket, whether they are able to stay Savio. Together, Savio, is a little tricky proposition for them in Velim. As far as Benavalim and Navalim are concerned, it is a fight between TMC and AAP. So, Congress is probably going to be third there. So, that is a problem for them, these two constituencies.
And what happened is now, for example, we have been hearing, this is nothing confirmed, you only confirm when you put in the, now we were hearing that this Wilfred Issa Babashan from Nuvem was supposed to resign from the BJP and stand as independent, backed by the BJP. And second thing is, in even in Veli, the minister, the fisheries minister who was earlier Congress, he was supposed to, but he's not standing as independent, that he is going to be joining the TMC. Now, is that going to be a plus factor? Like, are the people from Veli to be, you know, just because of a symbol, are they going to be, okay, fine, now he's left the BJP, can we vote for him or not? What do you all feel about this particular move?
I don't agree with this proposition.
Okay.
Because Nehru was the head in the country.
Mm. Exactly.
Yeah. Mm. Now, he joins, one day, fine morning, he was night time, he joins BJP. And when the election comes, he will resign from BJP and contest as an independent or Congress.
Or TMC.
Yeah.
Congress, I don't think they'll take
him.
People
will not accept him. Though he has got very sizable followers in his constituency.
Mm. So but not winning.
Not winning, I don't think.
No. Actually. I come to this point that I had made in my earlier submission. He seems to the survey seems to be giving it either to the BJP or to the Congress.
Veli Congress.
Whichever.
Yeah.
On the basis of their vote share.
Yes.
Okay. But it is not counting how many other parties are going to be in the fray there.
Yes.
How many other candidates are going to be there in the fray? If you go by in Kurtori, if you go by Reginald versus another one candidate, Reginald wins hands down.
Okay.
You got it. Again, Veli. The Congress gives the ticket to one of its three contenders. At least one of the other two contenders is going to rebel. Because they have already invested money into the whole political thing for the last 6-8 months, 1 year. In fact, the Zilla Parishad election, that Sarpanch of Veli, Savio, has funded the entire Congress campaign in that Veli ZP N1. So he is with so much of investment already done, he is not just going to back out at the last minute by not getting the ticket. So who wins ultimately at least in 5 out of the 8 constituencies depends on who are the local candidates and how many candidates are going to be there in the fray.
But BJP is nowhere.
BJP is nowhere in those four. That's what I'm saying. BJP is nowhere. Again, I tend to agree with what Sawal is saying about Philip Neri. You can fool the people once, you cannot fool the people all the time.
I don't know, we'll see.
in that 2002 election it was.
Yeah.
Last minute he went as a independent and went through because the opposition was not organized.
At that time.
At that particular point of time.
Now today
the same South Goa District Congress president was also in the picture then in 2002. He was a ZP member at that time.
Joe.
But they were not organized. Today they are organized.
Everybody is organized.
The opponents are organized. Mm. So last time he pulled the bluff. This time he is unlikely to pull the bluff.
Also,
Philip Neri is in deep shit.
Also in Velim, AAP is also a factor. We've got good number
point.
Of votes Cruz for
there.
Cruz
is pretty strong there.
He's pretty
Cruz
strong.
Is pretty strong.
So that's what I'm saying. It all depends on the dynamics of how many candidates are going to be. If you look at it as number one versus number two, then you can give the
but
seat
actually
to anyone.
This time, Viraj, it is not going to be number one versus number two.
Exactly.
It is going to be number one versus number four more.
Four more.
5,000 votes are going to be, you know, we are talking about, say, even a party like, say, TMC, 7% of the votes. is about 3,000, 2,000, 3,000, 11%, 3,000, 4,000, 5,000 party votes. If the candidate brings 1,500 votes, is through. You just look at the figures, because
so that
here the margins are what, 800, 1,000, 1,500. It is not the Valpoya and Satari where 2,000, 3,000 or 4,000 votes. Very interesting it's going to be. Okay, now leaving Salset aside, let us go to a neighbor. Neighbor means... No. I want to go to Kepe. Now, Kepe is an interesting constituency, because in our earlier thing, Babu Kavlekar was almost... through. Now, this time what figures are coming are showing some other figures. Viraj, I think you better explain this.
Yeah, so in our last round of survey, Babu Kavlekar was winning by a decent margin. I wouldn't say a very high margin like maybe Nilesh Kabral. Now the trend is, we throughout December when we were going, every time we went, after a few days, Elton's numbers are increasing. And Babu Kavlekar's numbers are going down. So Elton is gaining momentum. Last time around, people were not recognizing him. He was new in the picture. Now he seems to have gained momentum in his campaigning. And it is coming pretty close. Another factor there is, it looks like it's going to be a one-on-one fight. So one-on-one fight with a sitting MLA and a sitting minister is always a risky affair, because opposition votes get consolidated. And that momentum could be risky for Babu Kavlekar in Kepe.
Okay, I'll not put this out to you all. I'll bring back again. I want to talk about our famous PWD minister. In his constituency today, I don't know what the surveys are, but according to our feedback on the ground, the BJP ticket, probably another contender could be a stronger person to win Pauskar. Viraj, again to you before we keep it open.
Yeah, so Sawadde, it's like a BJP constituency. Both the strong candidates are from the BJP. Here again, now it has shifted. Initially, it was with Pauskar, but the trend is shifting. Ganesh Gaonkar is gaining ground. He is more stronger than Pauskar and by a decent margin. So he should, I mean, BJP should be giving the ticket to him. Another factor to note is, if he doesn't get the ticket and if he contests on some other ticket, maybe TMC, Congress and Independent, he could be a force to reckon with, which might not happen if it happens the other way around. If Pauskar doesn't get the ticket and he contests as an independent or on some other ticket, that might not happen. So this is something, this is a constituency where BJP has to take a call. It's for them to lose the constituency, because Congress is not in the picture. MGP has a candidate, but he is getting very small amount of responses.
Yeah.
Deepak Pauskar is a
MGP.
And then he joined BJP. And he has charges for employment. He has to get the inquiry is going on. He inquiry to report kite ata koi.
Official inquiry report or unofficial report?
They have already got. They have already got.
That's what I am asking.
And what I fear, that he may lose the ticket for BJP.
What about, you think people will forgive him for the roads? It's hard, and then actually.
These roads are, not only
Sawadde. But he though PWD minister?
Yeah, but Sawadde Madda Sangatani Brother.
Actually.
Yeah, so that again also depends on who are the
opponent.
Faces.
No, opponent is Pauskar versus
Govindan. Yeah, yeah. But there is also that MGP guy, what's his name?
Gaonkar.
Balaji Gaonkar. So he's not very strong according to our survey. His fan base is restricted only to that Dhar Bandoda area.
Exactly. So for all you care, the MGP might just adopt Pauskar. Who knows?
No, they have a stance that they'll not take any defectors.
No. They were very close. Will not
they will never be taken back. So they will not go for
I don't think Pauskar they will take back. So, I don't know, maybe, who knows.
Anyway, Sawadde has never re-elected a MLA. Mm. The first MLA was not Anil Salgaonkar, before Anil Salgaonkar.
Vinay Tendulkar.
Vinay Tendulkar.
Yeah.
after the then there was Anil came next term. After Anil was Ganesh Gaonkar. After Ganesh Gaonkar is first.
Even Shiroda, I think only one term, no MLAs.
No. Shiroda, Subhash has won four, five terms in a row.
Okay, we won't go to Shiroda, but yeah. Murmugao.
Before going there, let's also discuss Kankona. So, because Kankona has a similar situation, there is Isidor and there is Ramesh Tavadkar, both from the BJP, and both, it's like a similar situation like Savadne. So, there again, both of them have their vote share, and who gets the ticket is.
But I think BJP in Kankona, whoever comes, I think BJP would sail through.
Yeah,
I
because
think,
then the Congress has no face there.
Yeah. Because I can't ticket you now.
Kona.
रमेश
सावडकर इजिदोर देन द अदर्स आर लाइक 10-12% नॉट मोर देन दैट बोथ ऑफ देम आर गेटिंग अराउंड 30% ईच
ओके So even okay, anyway. So Murmugao.
So Murmugao, the thing is, Murmugao constituency, the advantage seems to be with the Congress. A strong advantage. Daboli advantage is with BJP because of Marvin Gudino. Vasco, BJP has gotten Daji Sarkar, and the sitting MLA who has resigned and joined the Congress, Carlos Almeida, he is with the Congress now. So it was going against the BJP. This is one constituency where we had to redo the survey. It was going against the BJP, but since Daji Sarkar has joined BJP, they have gained some momentum there. Their chances have increased, but it could be anyone's take. Coming to Kortalem, it is like even last time it was a four-way fight, and it seems to be going that way. There is AAP, there is Congress, there is BJP. Who I had to decide their candidate, and there is Antonio Vaz, who was the biggest factor last time around as well. He will definitely contest, and again it's up for grabs for anyone. This is one constituency where we are not calling it. It's very difficult to give it to either of them, so anyone could win.
Okay, here I would put a little bit of a disclaimer that here this is one constituency wherein I think besides Aldona, I think AAP as a party has got a very big vote share. Now, she's been a BJP, the present AAP candidate, the probable candidate, has been a minister, I don't know.
Yeah,
minister,
one term minister, in
and
minister.
Now she's joined, so I don't know. That is again open. But Murmugao seems, once upon a time, it was a four BJP MLAs. This time, what do you all think?
This time, he's giving them one.
Which one?
I think he's giving them Vasco, right?
Daboli. Everybody will agree with me.
Marvin. I don't know. Let's see what Ashley has to say on this.
No, I go by in every constituency. The only seat I say cocksure someone is going to win is Digambar Kamath Margam. I am willing to put my neck on the block. For the Margam seat.
Probably because even the BJP wants the government to win.
Whatever.
Because this is not what I am saying. This is what BJP can, the probable candidate, Desh Prabhu has said.
BJP candidate,
boy, he moved back. No?
Yeah, so that is the only seat I am locking today. Okay. Every other seat, whether it is Marvin, whether it is Michael Lobo, whether it is anybody.
Not and even the chief minister.
To some extent, the chief minister and your Vishwajit.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Other than these three or four sitting politicians, I cannot, as of today, for sure say any of them is going to get re-elected, including Marvin Gudino.
Okay.
For the simple reason that your COVID third wave is starting again.
Yes.
I'm not talking of the wave and the pandemic affecting the campaigning or whatever.
Business.
Talking of it affecting people's
business, livelihood,
incomes. It affecting people's livelihoods. People who are earning on a daily basis, not people who have salaries. People who have salaries are cool. But a big chunk of Goans, I'm telling you, people who get a regular salary are just 30 to 40% of Goans. 60% of Goans earn a daily wage. Whether it is small businesses, whether it is selling fish, or it is giving some services of a plumber or electrician or whatever,
or contractors, sector.
With this third wave coming in, their incomes are going to get affected. The sentiment, the anti-incumbency sentiment is going to be stronger. And the anti-incumbency is not only against the BJP. The anti-incumbency is against the incumbent. Whether it is from the BJP, Congress, MGP or whoever. So if that anti-incumbency quotient increases, your Marvin Goodino is gone, your Michael Lobo is gone, everybody is gone.
Okay, now let me just to sum up, since we are like almost out of time, let to sum up, who are the sure MLAs are going to win? Let me say, you agree, disagree. Digambar Kamath, as you said, Chief Minister Pramod Sawant, so the leader of opposition and Chief Minister, Magir the Rane Jr.
Vishwajit Rane.
Junior, Rane Jr. Any Sudhin Dawlekar, these four guys?
Yes, Sudhin Dawlekar, I agree.
Everybody has itle shaky?
Guarantee dung chakana. That is my point.
Yeah. Fair enough, absolutely. Viraj, do you agree, disagree? What do you say? Now you are the numbers man.
We feel it's slightly more than that. Someone like Rohan Kaunte, Marvin Goodino, they're pretty sure of winning. Not 100% sure, but see again, 80-90% is good enough in an election.
100%, we don't want 100%, 90-10%. Whatever, okay, fair enough, fair enough.
Anything can happen.
Yeah, elections, anything can happen, absolutely.
No,
but anyway.
It's also about who's there in the opposition. Sometimes opposition candidate is not strong enough, and then.
No, but these four people doesn't matter.
No, four people does.
These four people, it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter who stands. That's what I'm telling you. I think probably if, like, say, even if Rahul Gandhi comes and stands against Pramod Sawant, I don't think it will make much effect anyway. So leaving that aside, thanks guys, it's been interesting, but I don't know, I'm as confused as I when I started this discussion as I am now. So at least we have managed to zero down on four candidates who are going to win. That is a big plus given the present situation, political situation. Thanks, Viraj. Thanks, Sawant Bab. Thanks, Ashley.
Thank you.
Thank you. And keep watching Goa 365.